Hello everyone, this is Dominika from Creative at Home team, and today I will show you how to use Padlet for your creative work. So what is Padlet? Padlet is a kind of a virtual board which you can use for work with your students or make a discussions, some scholarships and so on. You can post messages on the board that you create in the application. You can also use it as a workspace for your group, for your team. Share some stories, messages, feedbacks on your training and so on. So, how to use Padlet? We will see now. Okay, so to use Padlet, we need to go to the new page, padlet.com. Okay, first of all, I will show you how to log in. So, to log in or register your account, you can use Google, Microsoft, Apple, or use your address email. I already have my account, so I will log in by my address email. Okay, and now you can see how the application looks like. So I have some of Padlets over here, but we will create a new one to show you how to use the application. In the free version of tool, you can make maximum 5 Padlets, but it's not that bad because you can remove the old Padlets and that just create a new one. So to make a Padlet, we need to press make a Padlet. You can choose between wall and between wall with the sections. Wall with the sections is almost the same option as wall. So I will show you this one because we have all the things that we need for now to show you how the application works. So you can change the title of your Padlet. For example, Creative at Home as the name of our project. Now it's Creative at Home. You can also change the wallpaper, so how the Padlet looks like. You can choose between the normal colors and a lot of different patterns. You can even upload your own image to your Padlet. So we will choose the new one, maybe yellow one, as the color of the project. And you need to click save to save the changes. Then you add some notes on your Padlet, so you can change the color of font and the font of the notes. It's fine for us, but if you want to change it, you can change it whatever you want. What's the most important option in the Padlet? You can press plus over here and you can check all of your things that you need. You can upload image, you can upload link. Let's say, maybe we can write the link. So, creativitycluster.eu. Okay, and now you can publish the note. Now it's without anything, but you can add another one and write Creative at Home application is useful, or what do you think? So now you can see that here we have the link to the website because the application needs to proceed the link to show it over here. But now we have the application, we have the note that Creative at Home application is useful. You can add also some pictures, some files like PDF files, and other option with the pictures. So what's the most important? How to exactly use it? So here you have your dashboard, your board. You can share the link with all of your participants and students, and they can add links, they can add some notes. So here, instead of name of the Padlet, you can add even some questions. So what do you think about the training? How do you like working the groups and so on? And all of your participants, all of your students can answer over here, but by doing it on their phones. So it's very useful for some trainings and for work in the team. I hope that this tutorial was useful for you. If you want to see more of our tools, more of our tutorials, you can go to the webpage creativitycluster.eu and there check all of our work. So have a nice day.